Hello and welcome back to Ten Island Gaming. Today we have a match between Empire and Listenman, and we're playing 2400 points. This is my Empire army, and it's led by an Arschlechter. He's carrying White Cloak of Ulrich and Sword of Striking, and I have a level 4 with life. He has Power Stone and Talisman of Preservation. I have a BSB, he's carrying a Dawnstone and Dragon Helm, and also full plate armor and great weapon. And I also have a Warrior Priest on Warhorse, he's carrying Enchanted Shield. For core, I have 38 Halberdiers full command with a detachment unit of 5 Archers. I have 12 Inner Circle Knights full command, and they got steel standard as well. For special, I have 30 Flaglands, a great cannon, and a unit of 5 pistoliers. For rare, I have Celestial Hurricaneum, and of course the steam tank. My level 4 rolled Throne of Vines, Regrowth, Dwellers Below, and Earthblood. And my level 1 with Beast, of course, Vishan's Wild Form. So this is my 2400 points of Empire.
And this is my 2400 point Lizardman army, the threat from the jungle. Let's go into it. It's led by a level 4 Slun Mage. He's also the BSB. He has Becoming, Cogitation, Harmonic Convergence, Wandering Deliberations. So that means he has all the signature spells for spells. Magic items, he has Channeling Staff and Iron Curse Icon. For core, I have 5 units of 10 Skinks with Javelin and Shield. And I have 24 Soros Warriors with full command. For special, I have 3 Swarms in one unit. Then I have 10 Chameleon Skinks. Also have the Temple Guard unit, they have the Banner of Discipline and full command. Then I have 2 Pterodon units of 3. And to round it out, I have 3 Salamander Hunting Pack. This is a unit of 2 and this is a unit of 1. Of course, I also forgot the Ancient Stegadon. No upgrades on him.
Yes, Empire, first turn. I had no charges. I tried to generate 4 steam points with my steam tank, which I made. And I just moved up slightly. I turned my Hurricaneum in range so I can try to snipe these scout units here. Yes, on to shooting a magic. I managed to get off Throne of Vines, and I tried to cast inbound spell to these Chameleon Skinks here, but I failed. He managed to dispel them. For shooting, my steam tank killed off one salamander there, and he made them flee. And I also tried to shoot with my cannon here. I hit 2 of them, but I got 2 ones, so they survived.
Movement phase, no charges. I moved over the pterodons of this unit just to pluck down his war machines, his cannon. Then I moved on the left flank, the chameleon skinks and the other pterodon riders. Get behind him. Over here, I just formed a trap, basically, just to lure him in. And the skinks didn't rally, so they would probably flee the battlefield. Now it's on to magic and shooting. In the magic and shooting phase, I tried to cast Searing Doom on his steam tank, but he dispelled it with the dice. Then I tried to cast Spirit Leech, and he used the dispel score, also on the steam tank. Then I used Melkost to lower his movement and reduced it by one. And then I also cast Shem's Burning Gaze on the knights, killing one of them. In the shooting phase, it was a lot that happened. In the end, I think I killed
18 halberdiers.
18 halberdiers, yeah. Mainly with the salamanders, but also I dropped some rocks on them. And then I shot with the pterodons on the cannon and got off one wound. And on the left flank, my chameleon skinks killed his fast calf. Now it's on to Empire turn 2.
I had one charge. I charged my inner circle knights here into the swarms. I tried to make 4 steam points, which I made. And he went up here in the salamander, exactly in range and in arc from the house there. And I just moved up my Hurricaneum a little bit as well, but I put him so he could be in the range to inbound spell to the skinks over there, chameleon skinks. Yes, over to magic and shooting. I got double ones, but I actually got 2 extra. So I had 4 die against 1, but I only managed to get Earthblood on my steam tank there. And I tried to cast the inbound spell from the Hurricaneum to the Chameleon Skinks there, but I failed. Got dispelled. And for shooting, I tried to shot this Pterodon Rider to kill one, but it didn't reach. I hoped it would kill one so that the Chameleon Skinks could take a bad leadership test and flee, but my tactic didn't go as planned. Now turn to close combat. My Inner Circle Knights killed the swarms and overran. They overran 9 inches. A little bit scary here. My steam tank managed to kill the salamander unit there with the impact hits, so he stays there.
In the movement phase, I charged the cannon with the Pterodon Riders. The skinks, chameleon skinks, moved up in the rear of the flaglands. The Pterodons made a flag move over them to drop rocks and got in the flank of the Hurricaneum. Otherwise, I surrounded the halberdiers with my skinks and also in front of the knights here, placed my skinks so they can charge them. Otherwise, I remained here. I have a great overview with the Slum Mage and at the steam tank. Now we'll go on to the Winds of Magic and shooting. In the magic phase, I got a miscast on Fireball and got a Calamitous Disaster and blew up 8. So it's not really good, and I think I killed one halberdier for it. And then I also tried to cast Spirit Leech, but he dispelled it. I think he channeled 2 dice, so I didn't have much advantage. In the shooting phase, the skinks here made 1 wound on the steam tanks. The skinks here also killed one. Then one of these units killed 3 archers. Otherwise, that one rallied, so it couldn't shoot. The skinks here, the Chameleon Skinks, killed, how many is it? 8?
3, 6, 9, 11.
Yeah, and also dropped rocks on them. And now it's on to close combat. In the close combat, the Pterodon wiped out the cannon. Now it's on to Empire turn 3.
I charged the skinks there. I think I killed one knight in stand and shoot, right? Yeah. And I actually made my chariot into the woods, but he managed to survive. I had nowhere else to go. He should have arc, whatever I should do to charge me, and this Chameleon Skinks there is very dangerous for my Hurricaneum. So I made a decision after a long time to move into the woods, just to do as much as I can before it dies or something. And the steam tank moved into his Stegadon, and I shuffled my Flaglands up as much as I could, and hopefully we can bring them into combat. And I reformed my Halberdier unit into a smaller bus, just to went up a little bit closer to the steam tank. Yes, over to magic and shooting. I got 11 dice, quite lucky there. That include everything with the channeling and my Hurricaneum. But my opponent as well got 3 channelings, so yes, I think it was 11 to 8, I think. Yes. For magic, I cast Earthblood on my steam tank, which I made. I tried to cast Regeneration from my Warrior Priest in the Inner Circle Knights. He dispelled that. I cast Regeneration from that Archlector into the Halberdier unit, which he dispelled as well. The only spell I got, Earthblood and Regrowth, was the only magic I got off. I got off Regrowth to my Flaglands. I think it was 4 that turned back. For shooting I had nothing. Yes, on to close combat. My steam tank killed the Stegadon, and my Inner Circle Knights made the Skink flee. I didn't pursue. That was it for the close combat. Now to Lizardmen.
In the movement phase, I charged the Hurricaneum with the Tetradons in the flank, moved up the Chameleon Skinks in the back of the Flaglands, turned the Skinks and close enough to the steam tank so he cannot pivot up, then back down my main battle line just to get some distance to the knights. Over here I moved the Skinks up to block the charge from the knights and the Tetradon in the flank just to harass them a bit. I moved up the Skinks just to continue shooting. Now it's on to Winds of Magic and shooting. For magic I actually got 12 dice on the Winds of Magic, and the first thing I tried to cast was Spirit Leech. And he let it go on the steam tank and I lost 4 wounds. Then I tried
you got a very high roll, so I didn't want to use all my die.
Then I cast Searing Doom, but he dispelled it. The next spell I cast was Fireball on his Halberdiers, and I think I killed 2. And then finally I did Shem's Burning Gaze on the knights, but only killed 1. And for shooting, the Tetradon Riders killed 1 knight as well. The Chameleon Skinks killed 6 of the Flaglands. These Skinks killed the 2 Redirector Archers that I had left. And these Skinks killed 1 more Halberdier. Now it's on to close combat over here. The Tetradon did 1 wound and charging flags, so they won by 3. He didn't make his leadership 6, so he fled through these units. Actually got a dangerous terrain and took 3 wounds. So now it's on to Empire turn 4.
I tried to generate 4 steam points with my steam tank, which has 5 wounds left. I actually made it. Quite lucky there. Yes, I had 1 charge the knights into his skinks. And I managed to rally my Hurricaneum. Got the double ones. Very lucky as well. I moved up my help unit closer to steam tank. Hopefully I can wound him up a little bit. Heal him. And my Flaglands marched up. So maybe they can charge next turn. Yes, over to magic and shooting. Magic. I have no shooting left. I got 12 die, quite high roll. I managed to get off Earthblood again on my steam tank. I got off regrowth with a miscast on my steam tank as well, so he's now on full wounds. With the regrowth I got magical feedback, so every wizard and characters that can channel die took a strength 10 hit. My level 4 made it with the ward save, and my warrior priest made it as well. My level 1 there, she got a wound, and this hurricane saved it. He managed to survive. And my Arschlechter got one wound on himself. And my opponent dispelled Throne of Wines as well. That was it for magic. I used my breath weapon here on the skinks, and all that hit got killed as well. 7 skinks died. Close combat here. I managed to kill them. 5 of them died, and he fled. I did not pursue, which I think was a good idea, or else I would be flanked.
No charges, I backed away even further. I rallied the skinks so they moved up to block them again. The remaining skinks are pestering the steam tank so we cannot pivot. The pterodons got in the rear of this unit, and the chameleon skinks in the flank just to shoot them down. Same thing over here with the hurricane, just to pluck off that last wound. Now it's on to Winds of Magic and shooting. In the magic phase, I tried to cast Searing Doom on the steam tank, but he dispelled it. Then I cast Fireball into his halberds, and I think I killed 5. Then I also tried to cast Spirit Leech on the steam tank, but he dispelled it as well. In the shooting phase, I killed a couple of halberdiers, and everything else failed actually to wound, so not much. Now it's over to Empire, turn 5.
I had 2 charges. Inner Circle Knights charge the skinks again. Hopefully I can kill them this time. And my Flaglands charges his unit of
Temple Guards.
Yep. I turn my Halberdier unit here just to face the Chameleon Skinks. Hopefully I can have a really good magic phase and can maybe do Dwellers Below. we will see. Yes, off to magic. I tried to cast my Innate Bound spell on the Skinks, but he dispelled it. And I actually just tried to cast and wipe out this skink unit, hopefully make them to flee. I did Dwellers Below with a miscast, only killed 3 of them, and he managed to success his leadership, so that was quite bad for me. I got, I think it was Calamitous Detonation as a miscast. Which result in 5 dead halberdiers. That was it for the magic phase. Yes, close combat. I managed to kill the skinks this turn, finally. And here, I killed 5 temple guards, and he killed 11 flaglands from me. But I am unbreakable. Turn 5, Lizard Man.
I just back down here because his knights are gonna charge in. Here I moved out of so I can stand and shoot, and just put them in the flank. Here I surrounded the Hurricaneum to hopefully finish up the last wound. Now it's on to Winds of Magic and shooting. I tried to cast Spirit Leech on the steam tank, but he dispelled it. Then I cast Fireball on the Halberd unit, depleted them, and then I tried to cast Searing Doom, but yeah, I got a low roll, so he lost concentration. For shooting, I didn't manage to kill this one with 20 shots with poison. Here I hit one but didn't wound, and here I think the Chameleon Skinks killed those 2. Yeah, something with them together.
You made a wound on the Arschlitter,
yeah.
And I saved actually four up.
Yeah,
so quite lucky there.
Now it's on to close combat.
Only one combat. The Flagellants hate themselves so much, so they killed them. They killed themselves before the combat actually began.
Now it's on to Emperor last turn.
I had one charge, which I made. The Inner Circle Knights there in the Saurus Warriors, and I tried to reach these Pterodon Riders, but I got short 1 inch, unluckily there. But that's the way. That was my charges onto magic. Yes, magic phase. It wasn't that much happening, but I tried to cast with my Warrior Priest over there, reroll 2 wound. But managed to dispel that. And yes, I tried to cast Earth Blood as well on my unit here, just to regenerate one lost wound there to my Arschlechter, so I get some points from that, and I succeed. So they have Earth Blood. I also tried to cast Throne of Vines, but dispel that and regrowth to my Hurricaneum, and he managed to dispel that as well. And for shooting, I had 1 steam point left to this Territon Rider, but he didn't wound. So yes, on to close combat. Close combat, the Inner Circle Knights won the combat by 4, I believe, but the Saurus Warriors is steadfast, so they pass the leadership to Lizardmen turn 6.
I only had one charge, the Temple Guards into the rear, the flank rather, of the Inner Circle Knights. Here I moved up just to finally, hopefully I can take the last wound from him.
Yeah.
And here I just surrounded his general and level 4 mage, so hopefully I can win.
Looking dark.
Yeah, hopefully I can take the last wounds. Let's go to the Winds of Magic. In the magic phase, I got on Melkos Mystic Frame Asthma, lowering the weapon skill with 3 on the Inner Circle Knights. Then also got off Ice Shard Blizzard, so they're -1 to hit. And on the Temple Guard unit, I got off Wizen's Wild Form.
Pretty heavy.
Yeah.
Pretty heavy.
In the shooting phase, I killed the Hurricaneum, and also I managed to kill the level 4 and the general.
Boo!
Luckily.
Only so, the steam tank.
The steam tank stands, and now it's this combat. In the close combat, I almost finished them off, his BSB, but he actually got a double 1, so he's staying around. But then we noticed that we're actually doing the Blood and Glory scenario, so when his general died over here, that was actually game.
The GG.
So, yeah, it was a fun game, and yeah, it could have gone either way. I think we were a bit careful, and no one made many mistakes, so it was a really good game.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you.
See
in a couple of days with a new battle report.
Thank you.
Thanks. Bye.